Hello again, our most valued student. My name is Confident. Welcome to Euclidean Geometry, and we are looking at theorems, and we are continuing to look at theorem 3. And again, if this is the first time coming in contact with this channel, I will encourage you to subscribe and ensure that the notification bell is turned on. This will ensure that every time we post a video, YouTube is going to notify you. So if you are watching this channel and you are benefiting, remember, go and subscribe. Just subscribe now, look down, turn on that bell so that you can be notified every time there's a new video. Now let us look at theorem 3. It says the angle subtended by the diameter at the circumference of a circle is 90 degrees. And in short, it says angles in a semicircle. So I just want to put in a few things. It says the angle subtended by the diameter. And by the way, how do you come about that? How do you subtend an angle as a diameter? So if I can bring in my circle, just as we've been drawing. So if I can just bring in my circle here. So let us look at the compass. And let me bring in my circle here to say, if I have, as you say, a diameter here, so we have a circle, and here they are saying the angle subtended by the diameter. Now, what is a diameter? Remember, a diameter is the longest line that passes through the center. Is the longest line. It's a chord, but that particular chord is a chord that passes through the center. So if I'm able to draw a diameter, it would be a line like that passing through the center. It's not a good one. Let me try this one. This is much better. You see that particular line, and then I can call that line, let us call that line A, B. Now it's a special line. If it's passing through that center, we call that line diameter. So they are saying the angle subtended by the diameter. What is to subtend? Remember, you are moving from A, you are going to the circumference of a circle, saying the angle subtended by the diameter at the circumference. From the circumference, then I go to B. The angle that is formed, I think we have talked about subtending. The angle that is formed, they're saying that particular angle is a what? It is a special angle, and it is a what? A 90 degrees. So it's more like a right angle, like that. So we want to prove this particular theorem. Don't forget, we have a center somewhere there. So how do you prove this theorem? So on the proof of this theorem, the first part, you're going, okay, let's say A, B, let's make that point C. Now, the first part we're going to have is we are going to come up with this particular angle here to say what is that angle. Now, we call angle, so this point is point O. Remember, that is the center. So we are going to say angle A, O, B. That particular angle is equal to what? 180 degrees. Remember, we call these what? This is the angle in a straight line. It's 180 degrees. So we're going to say angle in a straight line. So now, since the angle in a straight line is equal to 180 degrees, now in the previous theorem, remember, we said the angle at center is equal to 2 times the angle at the circumference. So now we are saying the angle at the center, in other words, we are also saying A, O, B is equal to 2 times angle A, C, B. What is the reason? Angle at center equal to 2 times angle at circumference. Remember that. So this is the previous theorem that we just looked at. I think it is theorem number 2. Yes, the previous theorem that we looked at, we just looked at this one. So it says angle AOB is equal to 2 times angle ACB. But we know what is angle AOB. We just said angle AOB is equal to 180. So you can then say 180 degrees is equal to 2 times angle ACB. Now you need what? You need then to find what is ACB, because this is multiplying 2 times, you see, 2 times. The opposite of multiplication is division. You divide both sides by 2. So what we have? We have got here to say 90 degrees is equal to angle ACB. So now, which means that particular angle ACB is equal to 90 degrees. So we are proving what? We just proved that the angle subtended by the diameter at the circumference of a circle is 90 degrees. So the reason here is angles in a semicircle. So it's saying angles in a semicircle. All right, so that is how we are going to be proving that. So it doesn't matter you are proving it that way. What you need to know, just to repeat again on this theorem, if I have, let me again put in here, let's say I've got, let me just make it a little bit bigger this time, because I just want to extend this theorem here. So if I have in my look at this. So if I have that circle, and then as I said, I have my longest line being the diameter, a line that will pass through the diameter like that. Now, and that line is AB, so that is the diameter. Any angle that I'm going to subtend on the circumference will be a 90 degree angle. For example, if I move from A, let me do this. Let's say I've got certain points here. Look at this. Let's say I've got a point here. I'll call it point C, and then I've got a point here. I'll call it D, and then I've got a point, just random points. I've got a point here, point E, and maybe say lastly I've got a point here, point F. Look at the angles I'm going to form from A, from C, D, E, and F. So from C, if I form an angle, I move from A, look at the part, I'm always moving from A, go to the circumference and return to B. You see that? That particular angle is a 90 degrees. That's a 90 degrees. I can use again D. I start from A, go to D, and then from there, return to B. You see how it's like? That particular angle again is a right angle. It's a 90 degrees. I can use the same thing to E. So what do? I start from A. From A, I go to E, then from E, I go to D. I think it's a bit long there, but it's fine like that. Don't worry, in as much as it doesn't look like it, but that's a 90 degrees. I can do the same thing at what? At F. If I can start from A, remember the starting point is always A, go to F, and then after that, you go to B, always return. Remember the line is AB, and the angle that you're going to form here is a what? It is a right angle triangle. It doesn't matter where. All these are right angle triangles. So that is what that law is saying. Now there is a converse of that law, of that theorem. There is a converse. It says if the angle subtended by the chord at the circumference of a circle is at 90 degrees, then the chord is a diameter. So when I'm talking about the converse of this theorem, what we're saying is, if you have it's the same law. That's why in here the reasoning behind says converse of angles in a semicircle. So what you are saying is, if I have a circle like this, let me just draw a circle. So I got a circle like this. So they are saying if the angle subtended by a chord at the circumference of a circle is 90 degrees. So they are saying, if for argument's sake, I have got a line, and that particular line I just draw like this. I just want to make it funny, not passing through the center. I know this becomes like the center, or can I erase that? Yes, like that. That is good. I like this. So they are saying, if it happens that if the angle subtended by a chord at the circumference of the circle is 90 degrees. So suppose I just have a random line. That particular random line is drawn like that. You see what I'm having? And that line is called AB. So they're saying if the angle subtended by this chord, so it's chord AB, and then I'm going to subtend an angle at the circumference. For example, you do that, and then I do that. Let's call that point C. And then that particular angle, they are saying, if it is 90 degrees, then they say, then the chord is a diameter. Then you must know that this particular line is called the diameter. It is passing through the center, so just know that it's a diameter. It's the longest line, and that line is called the diameter, meaning the center is along that line. The center lies of the circle lies along that line. So it's a converse theorem. So what do you do? If they are prove that AB is a diameter, what are you going to prove? You're going to prove that this is 90 degrees. The moment you prove that this is 90 degrees, it means AB is a diameter of a circle. What is the reasoning? The converse angles in a semicircle. So all right guys, we've come to the end of our lesson where we were looking at theorem number 3, and in brief, theorem number 3, what does it say? It says angles in a semicircle, meaning the angle subtended by the diameter at the circumference of a circle is a 90 degrees. Very easy to prove. Have your line AB, that angles in a straight line is 180, and then remember angle at center, this angle is equal to 2 times that angle, and that's how you prove that, and then you are done. Join me again when I'm looking at theorem number 4. Remember, 3 things to do: subscribe, turn on the notification bell, share the channel, and comment. Thank you.